Hey guys, welcome back to Genealogy and Chronology. Today, we will be discussing about the complete genealogical history of the Eastern Chalukya dynasty, which ruled over present-day Andhra Pradesh and parts of Telangana, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu states between 624 AD and 1279 AD. This chart is part 2 of a 4-part series on the Chalukyas of Deccan project by Genealogy and Chronology. Please consider subscribing to my channel as I will be discussing more about genealogies and history of Indian royal houses in coming weeks. Let's move on to today's topic. The Eastern Chalukyas, who are also known as the Vengi Chalukyas, were a junior branch of the Badami Chalukya Royal House. Badami Chalukya dynasty started ruling over the Western Deccan regions around 520 AD and in 624 AD during the reign of the 4th Badami Chalukya king Pulakeshin II, the Eastern Deccan region around Vengi broke away from the Badami Kingdom under Pulakeshin's brother Kujba Vishnuvardana I. After 624 AD, the descendants of Pulakeshin II would rule Western Deccan region, whereas the descendants of Vishnuvardana would rule Eastern Deccan regions. In 641 AD, Kujba Vishnuvardana passed away and he was succeeded by his son Jayasimha I. The first 3 centuries of Vengi rule saw stable governance of many famous kings such as Kujba Vishnuvardana, Jayasimha I, Vishnuvardana II, Vishnuvardana III, Vijayaditya I, and Vishnuvardana IV. By 753 AD, Badami Chalukyas lost power in the west and they were replaced by famous Rashtrakutas of Manyakheta. The Rashtrakutas sacked the capital of Vengi multiple times, but soon the two kingdoms became allies. In 772 AD, Vijayaditya I passed away. His son Vishnuvardana IV became king and married Silabhattarika, who was daughter of Rashtrakuta king Dharavarsha. Both the Rashtrakutas and Vengis prospered for a period of time between the reigns of Vijayaditya II, Vishnuvardana II, Vijayaditya III and Chalukya Bhima I. What followed next was a period of uncertainty for both Rashtrakutas and the Vengi Chalukyas. After Chalukya Bhima I passed away in 921 AD, a civil war and succession crisis engulfed Vengi Chalukyas. 6 kings from 3 different branches reigned within a span of just 7 years. It was Chalukya Bhima II, grandson of Chalukya Bhima I, who was able to restore some level of order in the country. The Vengi Chalukyas continued to face another threat in the form of Kalyani Chalukyas, who were their distant cousins. After the death of Chalukya Bhima II, the Vengi Chalukyas again faced a civil war where 2 different branches of the royal house fought for power. With the help of Kakatiya chieftain, Dhananava was able to ascend the throne in 970 AD, but his rule lasted for only 3 years. In 973 AD, Dhananava was killed by Chatachoda Bhima of the Telugu Choda family. He usurped the throne for 26 years from the Vengi Chalukyas. 973 is also the year when the rule of the Rashtrakutas came to an end following the establishment of the Kalyani Chalukya dynasty by Thailapa II, who was a descendant of the Badami Chalukya royal house. In 999 AD, Saktivarman I, son of Dhananava, overthrew Chatachoda Bhima and reclaimed his kingdom. With the rising power of the Kalyani Chalukyas in the west, the Chola Empire was looking for allies to defend its territories. The Chola Emperors started to interfere in the Vengi Chalukya affairs from this point in history. In 1011 AD, Chalukya Emperor Rajaraja I supported Vimaladitya, who was brother of Saktivarman I, and installed him on the throne. He also gave his daughter in marriage to him. In 1018 AD, Vimaladitya passed away and he was succeeded by his son Rajaraja Narendra. Narendra married his first cousin and Chola princess Amangai Devi. Between 1031 and 1035 AD, Vijayaditya VII, who was half-brother of Rajaraja Narendra, seized the throne for 4 years from Rajaraja Narendra. In 1035 AD, with the aid of the Chola army, Narendra was able to overthrow Vijayaditya and he started his second tenure as king of Vengi. In 1061 AD, Rajaraja Narendra passed away and Vijayaditya VII again usurped the throne and this time he ruled for 14 more years. By this time, the Chola Empire was facing its own issues with the rising power of the Pandyas, Hoysalas, and the Western Chalukyas. Following the death of the Chola Emperor, Virarajendra Chola, his son Atirajendra became emperor, but he died shortly after ascending the throne. Despite being from a female branch of the royal house, and despite many male Chola princes still being alive, Kulotunga I, son of Rajaraja Narendra, saw his opportunity and established himself as Chola Emperor. Kulotunga I reconciled with his uncle and allowed him to rule over Vengi until his death. In 1075 AD, Vijayaditya VII passed away. As Kulotunga I was heir to the throne of Vengi, he incorporated Vengi as a province of Chola Empire. Kulotunga I also married his first cousin and Chola princess Madhurantaki Devi. After reigning for 47 years, Kulotunga I passed away in 1122. He was succeeded by his son Vikrama Chola as the Chola Emperor and Vengi King. Vikrama Chola reigned for 11 years and in 1133 he was succeeded by his son Kulotunga II. Kulotunga II's sister married her third cousin who was a direct mainline Chola prince. Kulotunga II reigned for 17 years and in 1150 he was succeeded by his son Rajendra Chola II. Rajendra Chola II had a long reign of 23 years. As he did not have any suitable heirs, he was succeeded by his first cousin Rajadiraja II. Rajadiraja was a maternal grandson of Vikrama Chola and great-great-grandson of Virarajendra Chola. This meant that a direct male descendant of the Chola royal house ascended the throne after 100 years. The decline of the Cholas started under him. After a short reign of only 5 years, Rajadiraja II was followed by his son Kulotunga III. He tried to expand his kingdom to its former glory, but his victories in battles were short-lived. Kulotunga III married a Hoysala princess since the two kingdoms started to become allies. Kulotunga III passed away in 1216. Vengi was lost to Telugu Chodas around the same time, and later the Kakatiyas united all Telugu lands under one kingdom. Rajaraja Chola III succeeded his father over a very diminished Chola Empire. In 1246 AD, Rajaraja Chola III was overthrown by his brother Rajaraja Chola III. In 1279 AD, the Cholas lost a major war against the Pandyas. This concluded the rule of the mighty Chola Empire. After the collapse of the Chola dynasty, the princes of the Chola dynasty and the Vengi dynasty became feudatories of the Kakatiyas, Hoysalas, and Pandyas. They continued to rule over small fiefdoms but never rose to power again. I hope you all like this complete overview of the royal house of the Eastern Chalukya dynasty. In last week of this month, I will be going over the Rashtrakuta dynasty family tree, which is part 6 of the 12-part series in the history of Telangana project by genealogy and chronology. Later in the month of May, I will be dropping the Badami Chalukyas family tree, which is going to be part 3 of this series. You can watch the videos of the other 5 dynasties that ruled over Telangana after the Western Chalukyas by clicking on the playlist on my channel. Please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel and share this video with your friends and family. If you want a printed copy of this chart and you live within India, please reach out to me. If you like my work, please consider supporting me on Patreon, or you can buy me a coffee by scanning this code. Thank you.